Hi, welcome to another Mickleween video, and today we're going to be doing a Chucky transformation. So let's jump right into it. So first thing I did is put in my contacts, which are these blue things I got from, I can't remember. But yeah, blue contacts to match Chucky's blue eyes. So let's get started. So I'm going based off of a reference picture of Chucky's face to know where to put the scars and where to do everything. So here's the picture I'm going based off if you are wondering what I'm using. So first thing I'm going to use is a Meron bruise wheel, and I'm going to take the red shade and I'm just going to sketch and outline where the scars are going to go. Now I'm going in with some Ben Nye setting powder, and I'm just setting the paint so it doesn't smudge when I add on another layer of paint afterwards. Now I'm going in with the Meron bruise wheel once again, and I'm taking a darker, like, burgundy shade, and I'm just trying to add, like, some, like, I don't know, a layer of color, because like it's a wound isn't just like bright red, it has like darker shades to it. So I'm just trying to add like some dimension to the scars to make it look more, I don't know, realistic. Now I'm just taking some white and I'm doing the little staple marks. I was originally going to do like actual staples and just like glue them to my face, but I didn't have the time to do that. So yeah, I just took some, I just painted on some fake staples. And now I'm just taking some fake blood and filling in those wounds to make it look more wet. You know, like his scar, like the scar around his eye and on his forehead looks kind of fresh. So I'm kind of making it look, I'm trying to make it look more like wet and fresh, like it's a brand new wound. Can't really see it, but I'm going in with some black just to add some dimension around the edges of the wounds, just to make it look like it's more like deep and prominent. But of course the mirror's in the way, so that's my fault. And again, just going in with some black to add like little holes on the side of the staples to give it like that aesthetic of like, oh, I have something puncturing my skin, and just to add some dimension to the staples. And here's your final look. What I did off camera was added more staples on the forehead, as you can see. What else did I do? Yeah, just more staples, more dimension, and put on my overalls, put on my wig, and there you go, your Chucky costume. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. Make sure you thumbs up, comment down below, and tell me, is this the easiest look you've probably seen? Probably. If you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button, because every time you subscribe, I become a little bit more magical. Don't forget to hit that bell notification to be the first person to watch the video when it first comes out. So yeah, as always, thank you for watching. I'll see y'all next time. Bye.